Well, we're just dropping Sarah off to the field so she can bush hog. If you remember from the last video, we had a little fan belt slash alternator belt issue with this tractor. So we've got that going again, and hopefully she can get finished up with chopping stalks here in the next couple days. So we just stopped at Dunkin' Donuts. How was your breakfast sandwich?
Wonderful.
Wonderful, yeah. Well, let's not break anything today.
Oh, we'll see.
All right. So you got this piece here, then over on Hollow Hill.
Yeah.
And then on to East Hill, Marcellus.
Okay.
All right.
All right.
All right, don't get stuck.
Oh.
All right, so I have to, you're all set. I have to run down to Fleet Pride and grab a drive shaft section for the fire truck. We'll make sure she gets up and going here. And then we'll get back to the shop. Alright, we've got this truck pulled in here. This used to be an old truck that belonged to Navarino Fire Department. We bought it from the fire department. It's a 2008 F-250. And this is the drive shaft that I picked up down the Fleet Pride. It's got three new U-joints in there and a new carrier bearing. And that was $400. It looks like they probably, yeah, they replaced the front section. So it's the front section along with the carrier, three U-joints, $417. So we're going to go ahead and get that in there. You're probably wondering how I was able to get the truck in the shop. It is four-wheel drive. Just pull the four-wheel drive stick back into gear and you got front-wheel drive. So we'll go ahead and get this in there. And then we've got some other stuff that we're going to be working on as well. We need to get this out, pull the W900 in. We've got some front spring shackle pins to replace on it. So let's go ahead and get this bolted in there quick and get this turd out of here. We've got this in there. It should be good for another few years anyways. The drive shaft is gonna outlast the truck here, so we'll get the jack stands rolled out from underneath this thing and get this thing out of the shop here. It has been pissing on me the whole freaking time while I've been working on it. So that's the trouble with working on things this time of year. You got the snow that builds up on the stuff, and then as soon as you bring it into shop, it's raining down on you the whole time you're working on it. All right, we're on our way over to the field. Sarah needs some fuel. I stopped at the gas station and grabbed her something to eat for lunch. And I've got Diesel Dog with me here. He hasn't been in one of these videos in a while, have you, Bob? But he absolutely loves riding in the truck. So I've just pulled into the field here and Sarah's on her way over to the truck and there is the phone. Right, Bob? Should I answer it? No? All right, I better answer. Hey, don't you get muddy now. Diesel. Don't you get muddy. I don't need to get my seat dirty. No, he wants back in the truck. how you making out?
Great.
Great? Just great?
I haven't broken anything yet.
Haven't broken anything yet, huh? So, snow's starting to melt off anyways. We got about half of this left. Well, she'll be full here in a minute, and we'll head back to the shop, I guess. What do you think, bud? Huh? You want to get back up in the truck and get back to the shop? So we just pulled up to where these guys are spreading manure. I got the frack tank set up right there. And I didn't get the drone up in time, but Nate just pulled away from it, and we'll go over and watch him spread off a load of manure here. So he is pulled up here now, and he is gonna start offloading manure. We've got the 9410 on the noon tanker over in that other field over there. All right, so Nate's just started to inject manure. He is running the 9320, which is pulling an 8,500 gallon James Way Max Track tanker. It's got a injector on the back of it, a six shank injector that we had gotten from Ortel Supply here this spring, and it's got Dietrich tips on it. Slowed down there for, he must be empty. All right, so he's empty. Just lifted up there. So he's gonna head back to the frack tank and get another load. All right, so Nate has pulled up to the frack tank with the other tanker here, and he is getting ready to load off of it, and we're gonna go ahead and get back to the shop here. We're gonna head back to the shop and see what kind of things we can get done here. What do you think, Bob? You gonna stay in the truck, huh? You're probably might want to stay in the truck just so that when we have to go somewhere, you'll be ready to go. All right, we're going to get back there. All right, I got the payloader in here. This is a roll-out bucket, so it's got a hydraulic attachment to it. Run off the third function in the payloader. We've got a faster coupler on here that runs the dump on the bucket, and then we also use this hookup for the defacer here. So it's got a leak on this side here. He's just running the bucket back and forth, and we're gonna make sure we're seeing what we're seeing here. He said that this doesn't leak when it's running the defacer, so we're led to believe that it is the bucket side, which is this coupler here. So I'm just looking for something to start dripping here. Go all the way or bring it down and hold it. I don't see nothing there. Now go the other way and hold. Well, we can replace the cartridge anyway, so pull it back, neutralize it, we'll unhook it, back away, and then we'll change that. All right, we weren't sure which side was leaking, so we replaced both of these. Just getting it back together here now. And I had to switch this hose out. We had the wrong size. We had the wrong fitting on, or on the other side. We had a 45 on there, so I ended up making a new hose. And what we use here is it's just fire hose. It's the outer sheath of fire hose, and it works great for hydraulic hose protection. This is just 2-inch or 1.5-inch fire hose. You just put that over the hose itself. Bang, bang. Right, Tim?
Yeah.
Well, we'll have to see how this goes. It's been leaking right along. Figure we'd get after it today. Pulls it in the shop. And it was the bucket side. And I said, well, let's make sure it is that side. He says it doesn't leak on the defacer, and I believe him because I've seen it leaking on the bucket. I thought it was going to be the payloader side. The bottom side, nothing leaking. So, we replaced both of these fittings on the top side. Just got to see how it goes tomorrow. So, but
that's the only other place you got, really.
Yeah, I mean, we can replace the couplers on the bottom, but
I don't know. See how this
goes. Yeah. Well, we're gonna see how this does there. He's just getting some oil added to it now. And we'll spray some brake cleaner or whatever on these fittings. And I have to keep an eye on it in the morning here. Well, Sarah's on the last farm. And apparently she blew a hose or something. So we've got to see what we've got going on here. What have we got? Hopefully it's on the bush hog and not on the tractor. This is no good. This is on the tractor. It's not on the...
No, it's like up there.
It's up there?
It's coming from like...
Oh. Ugh. Okay, so... Well... I think you're gonna have to start it up. in order for me to see it. So start it up quick and then shut it off. Do some research here before we can figure out where the heck it's coming from. Alright, try to lift that. Whoa! Come again. Try it again. Oh! Oh my god, this is too easy. This is too easy. It's this little guy right here. So, oh my god, that is too easy. I thought sure it was gonna be one of them lines down in there. All right, shut tractor off, we'll take this guy off and we'll take it back and get a new one. This is so easy, I think I could fix it with the tools that I have in my pocket. Like that there, and this here. There's that. That's where she's blown, is right there. Garbage. Garbage hoses. All right, I'll take this back and we'll make up a new one. It's blown right there. Well, you just can't seem to get this job done, can you? Every day she's gone out. Well, except yesterday.
No, yeah.
Yesterday you didn't have any breakdowns. But today we got one day left. Tractor blows a hose. Day before yesterday, which was a week ago today.
Yeah.
Maybe? Yeah, week ago today, she had the fan belt go. And then... Oh, the day before that, she had a solenoids on the bottom of the IVT transmission. They were letting oil down into the solenoid and then making goofy things happen, and the transmission would go into neutral. And then the time before that, she had a something with the park brake switch was activating itself and it would put the tractor right into park. So that was a warranty problem or a warranty job from some parts that they had replaced in the spring. So we'll have to get back to the farm, get a hose made, bring 15 or 20 gallons of oil and get that in there. I think we're gonna have to bring some soap and water for that back window. That back window is got a lot of oil on her. So that tractor is going to be even dirty now, even dirtier now to wash. Think you're going to be able to handle washing that?
Oh.
Huh? Ugh. That was a rough spot there. So we'll get back to the farm and get a hose made. All right, so if you want to get filling some pails, I'll start making that hose. If I get back around to this door, that might be a little handier. Okay. We've got our little hose made. We'll go ahead and get that on there. Then we're gonna fill this with oil and we're gonna just throw some soapy water on that window. However, I think she's only gonna be able to run here a little while longer. It's raining right along here now. If she gets this piece here done, that'll be good enough for today. And she's gotta do that piece up there yet and the one pass down through this lower strip on her way out through. So looks like we're gonna get a little wet here, but you know, last time I worked on this tractor it was in the snow.
Yeah. All elements here.
Yeah, got all kinds of weather, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah. If I can get up on here without slipping. Yeah, that should be all right. Made this hose a little longer just so that I didn't have so much of a force on here, but I don't know, as if maybe it shouldn't have been any longer. So we've got that on there. One thing I was worried about when I first looked at this, I thought it was going to be a brake line or something down in on top of the transmission, which would have been absolutely cute working on that in the field. So we'll go ahead and get some oil on this and get this cap off my other hand. And this tractor's going to need a good old bath here. Shove that there. You guys listen very carefully. You can hear Jared from here. He's running down through the valley, down through there. I can hear him right now. You can. Can you hear him?
Yeah.
You can hear him, can't you?
Yeah.
I don't know if the camera picked that up or not. Yeah. Listen carefully, you can hear him. Are you all set now?
Yeah.
Hey, you want to take the camera with you for the rest of this job?
No.
You could talk to the camera and say what you're doing and...
I think they know what I'm doing.
Oh, okay. All right. Well, I can't even say don't break nothing because every time I've said that, she's broken something. So, yeah. Well, it is what it is, so... If you can't go, call me. I'll come back down and pick you up. But it's been raining right along. So, all right, you all set? You need anything to eat or anything? No? Gonna be able to get it done?
Should be.
All right. Yeah. Okay.